Hey there, it's Kaylee. Now that we know so much about inequalities, we're going to apply them to the real world. Let's go! Let's start with some easy examples of word problems. This one says, a chocolate bar at the movie theater costs more than $4. And we need to write an inequality describing the cost, variable C, of the chocolate bar. So to start, I'm gonna write down my variable, which I know is C, the cost of the chocolate bar. And I know the cost, C, is more than $4. So more than, what kind of inequality symbol should I use to represent more than? Yeah, my greater than sign. So C, the cost, is greater than what? It tells us $4. Awesome. So that makes sense. C is greater than 4. Perfect. Now let's plot our solution set. To do that, we'll get out our number line here. And if I want to plot the inequality C is greater than 4, what do I do first? Yeah, I'll go find the 4 on my number line. I'm going to draw a circle here. Now, am I going to fill this circle in or do I leave it open? Well, it's just greater than 4. So that means 4 is not included in my solution set. So I have an open circle and then I'm going to draw my arrow in what direction? Yeah, in the direction of greater than 4. So my solution set does not include 4. It's at least bigger than 4 and goes all the way up. So if we wanted to get a chocolate bar at the movie theater, what do we need? What does our solution set tell us? Yeah, it tells us that we have to bring more than $4 to the theater. Nice. Okay, our next one says, Jenny is shorter than Paul. Paul is 57 inches. Write an inequality that compares Jenny's and Paul's height. And we're using the variable j to describe our unknown, which is Jenny's height. So I'm going to start by writing down the variable, which I know is j. And it says Jenny is shorter than Paul. So that means this j is going to be less than Paul's height. Let's say Paul's height was p. So Jenny is shorter, less than p. So we can say Jenny is shorter than p, but we know that this variable, because it tells us Paul is 57 inches. So we can say J is less than 57, which is Paul's height. So here we've written an inequality that compares J and P, Paul's height, which is 57 inches. And we know that J is less than 57 inches. Awesome. So now let's plot our solution set. We'll get out our number line here. And what am I going to do first? Yeah, I'm going to find my 57 here. So 57 would be somewhere between 55 and 60. So right here, I'm going to draw my circle. And now is 57 included in my solution set? No, right? Because it's not J is less than or equal to. It's just J is less than. So 57 is not a part of my solution set. And what direction will I draw my arrow? Yeah, that's right, towards zero or getting smaller because J is less than 57. Whew, my line's a little crazy there, but pretend like this is a nice straight line. And my arrow is going towards the zero because J is less than 57. Nice. Let's do one more together. This one says, Jamal can carry 25 pounds or less in his backpack. And we need to write an inequality describing the weight, W, Jamal can carry. So here again, I'm going to start by writing down my variable, which is W, the weight Jamal can carry. And this says Jamal can carry 25 pounds or less. So 25 pounds. So that means he can carry 25 pounds. So we have an equal to 25 pounds or a less than 25 pounds, right? So if we want to combine my equal symbol and my less than symbol, I'll have my weight is less than or equal to what? 25 pounds. So here's an inequality that describes the weight Jamal can carry. He can carry 25 pounds at most in any weight less than 25. So let's go ahead and plot our inequality. We have our number line here. And what do we do first on our number line? Yeah, we'll go and find this number. 25 is right here. I'm going to draw my circle. And is 25 included in my solution set? Do I fill in the circle? I do. How come? Yeah, because we have an or equal. So 25 is included. I represent that by filling in my circle with a nice pink dot here. Awesome. Now, what direction will my arrow go? Yeah, we're including 25 and everything less than 25 because that's what Jamal can carry in his backpack. Nice, you've totally got it. Look at you, translating real-world scenarios into inequalities and plotting their solutions. Now you can practice doing it on your own. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.